हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द SRBPS ऑनलाइन क्लासेस।
टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 2। आवर चैप्टर नेम इज प्लेइंग विद नंबर्स। आवर टुडेज टॉपिक इज प्लेइंग विद नंबर्स। क्लास, इट इज रियली वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू प्ले विद नंबर्स, राइट? So our first topic is operations on numbers. Class, when we are talking about the operations, so in maths here we are having four operations, that is plus, minus, multiply and divide, or we can say that addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So firstly we are going to discuss about our first topic, that is addition. The numbers which are added are called addends. It means whether we are doing plus of two numbers, three numbers, four numbers, all those numbers are called as addends, right? And the new number thus obtained is called sum. Class, after doing plus of all numbers of all those addends, the whatever the result has come, that is called as sum. Clear everyone? You can see also I have taken one example and I have added here two numbers, 2516 and second is 5321. So here we are going to add these two numbers. So these two numbers are called as addend. Clear? And after doing plus, whatever the result will come, that is known as sum. Clear? Now the question arises, how we will plus? Class, in example, here I have taken four digit number, but you are in 6th standard or 5th standard. So what we are going to do? We are going to do here the plus of 7 digits and 8 digits number. So in that case, what we are required to do? So our first step is we have to make the place value chart. Once again, I am repeating what we have to do. We have to make the place value chart. Ones, tens, hundred and last thousand. But when doing practically these questions, we will be having the numbers of more digits. So the place value chart will be used for the thousand, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, crore. Clear everyone? So our first step is we have to put the place value chart. Second thing is we have to put the numbers under these places. As you can see here, under the ones place I have put 6 and then 1, and then after that, after adding 6 with 1, the answer is 7. As I have written in the columns, it will be you can see here it is looking beautiful, the writing is neat and clean. When you will put the numbers under the places or in the columns, then you will not be able to do any mistake. Clear everyone? So first step is we have to make the place value chart. Second step is we have to put the digits under the places, or we have to arrange the numbers in the columns. Clear? And third, last, we have to plus. 6 plus 1 7, 1 plus 2 3, 5 plus 3 8, 2 plus 5 7. Hence our answer is 7837. Clear? Now we are going to study about the properties of addition. Properties of addition. Our first property is when two numbers are added, then the sum is the same regardless of the order of the addends. It means, class, when we are going to add two numbers or three numbers, then the answer will be same after changing the order of the addends. Clear? Let us understand this property with the help of one example. See here everyone. 351 is added or plus with 504. When we are going to add these two numbers, you can say when we are going to add these addends, or you can say as a number as well. So when we are adding these two numbers, we are getting answer 855. Here you can see 351 is at first place and 504 is the second number. But if I'll put 504 as first number and 351 as our second number, then also we will get the result 855. So you can see here after doing plus also, means after doing the plus, we are getting same number after changing the order. Here 351 is the first number, but here 351 is a second number. So have you observed, class? When we are changing the order of the numbers or the order of the addends, the sum will remain same. This was our first property. Now let's come to our second property. When 0 is added to a number, we get same number as the sum. As you already know about this property, that when we are adding 0, when we are adding 0 to any number, the same number will be only the sum. The same number we will get as a result. It is also known as zero property. It is also known as zero property. So, these are the two properties of the addition. So, we can easily plus when two numbers are given to you. Have you thought, class, if more than two numbers are given to you for the addition? So, in that case, what you have to do? In that case, you have to do grouping. How we have to add those numbers? With the help of grouping. See here, if we have to add more than two numbers or more than three numbers, then we have to group any of the two given numbers and add them. So what we have to do in that case, we have to make the group of the two numbers. And how we will make the group? With the help of these brackets, as you can see on my screen. Class, see here, three numbers are given for the addition. So you have to make the group of the two numbers. Now you can go for any way. You can group these two numbers, first two numbers, or you can group these last two numbers. Clear? So what I have done, I have add first two numbers. I have made the group of these two numbers with the help of this bracket. So after adding these first two numbers, I get as a result 357,621. And third number is 5,55,623. Class, when you will make the two numbers, or when you will make the group of the first two numbers, then you will write third number separately. After adding first two number, whatever the result you will get, you will plus the third number in that result. And you will get the final result after adding those two numbers. Clear everyone? So you can see here, with the help of grouping concept, we can easily add if the two, more than two numbers are given for the addition. Am I clear with this concept? Now let's come to the second operation, that is subtraction. The number from which the other number is subtracted is called minuend. What is called minuend? Once again I'm speaking, the number from which the other number is subtracted is called minuend. The number that is subtracted is called subtrahend. The number which is subtracted is called subtrahend. The answer which we get after subtraction is called difference. Class, after doing minus or after subtraction, whatever the answer we get, that is called difference. See here in the example, I have subtracted 67,429 from 70,000. So the number from which the other number is subtracted is called minuend. Yes, the number from which the second number is subtracted or the other number is subtracted, that is called minuend, and the number which is subtracted, that is called subtrahend. That is called subtrahend. Class, after subtracting, whatever the answer came, that called as difference. Clear everyone? So how to subtract? I think this concept is already known by you people, as you have already studied in your 3rd standard, 4th standard and 5th standard that how to subtract, right? Now let's move to the properties of subtraction. Properties of subtraction. Our first property of subtraction is, when the minuend is same as the subtrahend. When the minuend is same as subtrahend, then the difference is zero. Class, it means the number from which the other number is subtracted, that number, or the number which is subtracted, it means the other number. If these both are same, so the answer will be zero. When we'll subtract these number, the answer will be zero. Clear? This was our first property. Now let's come to the second property of the subtraction, that is, when zero is subtracted or when zero is the subtrahend, then the difference is the minuend only. It means when a zero is subtracted from any number, so the number itself is the answer. See here, I have subtracted 0 from 8976. So the answer is 8976. Whatever was the minuend, that is only our difference. So these are the two properties of our subtraction.